The assassin kicking away with me at ringside is our good friend Keith Hart, an outstanding wrestler. And Keith, we're sure glad to have you back here.
Yeah, it's my pleasure to be back. It's always great to be back in Calgary. I miss the place when I'm not here. I really miss the action.
I know you've been wrestling in the other parts of Canada.
That's right. We were all the way across. We went, made our inaugural northern tour to as far as Prince Rupert, and we were warmly received by the fans in Vanderhoof and Prince George and Houston.
That's really wonderful. I know we're getting letters from the fans all over the area where our TV reaches, and many organizations are writing in. They'd like to have wrestling matches in their cities. Right now, it's the Dynamite Kid. The referee, incidentally, is Wayne Hart. And Dynamite is working over the Cuban assassin pretty well into those, vicious kick by the Cuban. Incidentally, and among those letters we've been getting, people have been asking about, has there ever been any Canadian wrestlers in the Olympics? You know, with the Olympics coming up. And Earl McCready, a Canadian, was in the Olympics, wasn't he?
That's right. He was the only athlete to be inducted into the Hall of Fame in three countries. He's inducted into the Canadian, the U.S., and the New Zealand Hall of Fame for wrestling.
I know that Stu Hart, your dad, certainly the great, one of the greatest wrestlers that Canada ever produced. Canadian champion as an amateur and professional. Right now, it's the Cuban assassin. He has topped the Dynamite Kid, but Dynamite's in the ropes. That's an automatic break. So many people have been writing in about where the best wrestlers are, what country they're from, and a lot of people keep thinking about such stars as Jim Londos, you know, and the Greeks have had a great history of wrestling, haven't they?
Well, they're the ones who originated it, really, with the Olympic Games. But, Cuban Assassin has opened up a cut on Dynamite.
He sure has. It's pretty hard to beat the wrestlers right here in Stampede Wrestling, regardless of whether they're from Europe or not. Right now, Stu Hart has probably the most colorful wrestlers in the world.
Cuban's really putting on Dynamite. Dynamite's had a strong feud going with the Bad Rizal, and maybe he should have concentrated more on his match with the Cuban.
Right now, it's a rugged match. The Cuban has worked over Dynamite pretty thoroughly. Dynamite in trouble. The Cuban is up there. He reaches for the hair. He rips him up by the hair. Crashes him into the head, into the turnbuckle.
Sam, I missed it last week, but I guess it was an awful thing that had happened with Dynamite, what Bad News did with Dynamite's wife. And I apologize from all wrestlers in general for the disgraceful tactics of Bad News Allen. And it's just nothing we can do about him. I'd like to run him out of business. It's just a matter of finding somebody who's man enough to do it.
Well, it certainly was reprehensible. I understand our director and producer are going to show that incident again. So many people asked about it. Right now, the Cuban, with a modified sleeper hold, it's a reverse chin lock. He's punishing Dynamite. Twisting the head. Dynamite is thrown into those ropes. He ducks under it. Oh, what a drop kick. What a drop kick.
Oh, vicious. He just about kicked him right out of the ring. Solid. It wasn't high, but it was hard.
Dynamite with punches, forearm punches, forearm blows. And the Cuban's in trouble right now as Dynamite takes over. Uh-oh, he's got him now. He drops him head first to the mat. And that looks like it could be curtains for the Cuban assassin.
They're both tough men. They can take a lot of punishment. Dynamite took it at the beginning, but he's rallied now. Once he's mad, it's going to take a lot for the Cuban to turn the tables.
Dynamite. Dynamite working them over. They're in the corner. Man, what a high drop kick. Bad News Allen started to get into the ring.
Dynamite kid disqualified over the top rope.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're sorry to report that although Dynamite Kid was way out in front, he did throw the man over the top ropes, and he was disqualified. So the winner of the match.